Hello to all the children out there, class 12, right? So this is another video, and today we are going to start with what? We are going to start with methods of measurement of price elasticity of demand. Today we are going to start with methods of measurement of price elasticity of demand. Right? So we have read what is elasticity of demand. We have read what is price elasticity of demand. Now, we have already read the degrees of price elasticity of demand. They are perfectly elastic, perfectly inelastic, then unitary elastic, then elastic and inelastic. Right? Now, we are going to do the numerical part today. This is very interesting, and we are going to read this, that ki agar hum price elasticity of demand measure kar bhi rahe hain, तो कितने तरह की प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी डिमांड को मेजर करने के तरीके हैं. सो बेसिकली वी आर गोइंग टू डू थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ मेथड्स, राइट? द पॉइंट मेथड वी आर गोइंग टू डू, पॉइंट मेथड एंड टोटल एक्सपेंडिचर मेथड एंड ज्योमेट्रिक मेथड और प्रोपोर्शनेट मेथड आल्सो. सो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद व्हाट? वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद परसेंटेज और प्रोपोर्शनेट मेथड. फर्स्ट मेथड वी विल डू इज परसेंटेज मेथड और व्हाट? और प्रोपोर्शनेट मेथड. दिस इज वेरी इजी, इजीली हो जाएगा. दिस इज, यू विल अंडरस्टैंड इट क्वाइट इजीली. सो प्रोपोर्शनेट और परसेंटेज मेथड, दिस इज द मोस्ट पॉपुलर मेथड ऑफ मेजरिंग प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड. Under this method, elasticity of demand is measured by the ratio of change in quantity demanded to change in price. Right? Here we are going to use the ratio of change in quantity demanded to change in price. Now, the formula for elasticity of demand is going to be, elasticity of demand is going to be your percentage change in quantity demanded to percentage change in price. So this is going to be a first formula of this method, and the formula is percentage change in quantity demanded to percentage change in price, right? Or you can say, or the another formula is for elasticity of demand is going to be delta Q upon delta P into P upon Q. That is another formula, delta Q upon delta P upon Q. So if you are doing it with percentage method, the very simple thing is that just see what is the change in quantity demanded percentage wise and just divide it by the percentage change in its price. You get this. Otherwise, another formula is same for proportion method, is delta Q upon delta P into P upon Q, where delta Q stands for change in quantity demanded, change in quantity demanded. Delta P stands for change in price, right? P stands for old price before change, for change, and Q stands for old quantity before change. So these are going to be the full forms, right? I hope it's clear to you. Yes, you can go through it. I'll read it and then we'll take an example also. So this is your first method, that is your percentage method or proportionate method. The formula is elasticity of demand is equals to percentage change in quantity demanded upon percentage change in price, or elasticity of demand is equals to delta Q upon delta P into P upon Q. Right, where delta starts for change in, and the rest is old price and old quantity. Now we can take up example also. This is the formula. So let's take example. We'll do suppose the price of ice cream is rupees 4. Price of ice cream is rupees 4 per cup. Per cup. ठीक है? Ice cream का price क्या है? Rupees 4 per cup है. Right? If the price of ice cream falls to rupees 2, if price of ice cream falls to rupee 2 per cup. अगर ये ऐसा हो जाता है, मतलब ice cream का प्राइस क्या हो गया है, 2 रुपया गिर गया है, ठीक है, मान लेते हैं डिमांड इंक्रीजेस. डिमांड इंक्रीज कितना कप, डिमांड इंक्रीज हो गया है टू फोर कप्स. राइट प्राइस ऑफ आइसक्रीम है 4 वन कप का, एंड डिमांड इज वन कप. ठीक है, तो ये क्वेश्चन हमने मान लिया, ये क्वेश्चन मान लेते हैं. प्राइस है आइसक्रीम का कितना है, प्राइस है आइसक्रीम का रुपीज 4 और डिमांड है 1 कप की. अगर प्राइस गिर जाता है 2 रुपए तो डिमांड कितनी जाती है, 4 कप आइसक्रीम की हो जाती है. तो हमारा जो ओल्ड प्राइस है पी, ओल्ड प्राइस इज इक्वल्स रुपीज 4. ओल्ड प्राइस कितना है, रुपीज 4 है. ठीक है, तो अगर हमको करना है डेल्टा पी करना है, मतलब चेंज इन प्राइस करना है. तो चेंज इन प्राइस करने के लिए आप क्या करोगे, P1 माइनस P इक्वल्स टू P1 का मतलब क्या है, यहाँ पे P1 का मतलब है यार न्यू प्राइस. 2 माइनस 4 गिव्स यू वस माइनस 2, राइट. तो माइनस 2 क्या है आपका, दिस इज योर डेल्टा पी, चेंज इन पी. क्वांटिटी की बात करें तो पहले आप कितने क्वांटिटी मांग रहे थे, 1 कप, राइट. नाउ अगर मैं बोलूं कि चेंज इन क्वांटिटी क्या है, डेल्टा क्यू क्या है, चेंज इन क्वांटिटी क्या है, तो व्हाट यू विल डू, Q1 माइनस Q, राइट. Q1 माइनस Q क्या होगा, Q1 माइनस Q इज गोइंग टू बी 4 माइनस 1. पहले 1 कप मांग रहे हैं, 4 कप मांग रहे हैं, इज इक्वल्स टू 3, राइट. तो 3 इज गोइंग टू बी योर डेल्टा Q. डेल्टा Q हो गया. नाउ इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड का फॉर्मूला हमने अभी आपको बताया था, व्हाट इज इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड. इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड इज पी अपॉन क्यू भी ले सकते हो, माइनस इनटू डेल्टा क्यू अपॉन डेल्टा पी, राइट. सो इफ यू पुट द वैल्यूज, सो वैल्यू पुट करें तो ये पी इज 4, पी इज योर 4, क्यू इज योर व्हाट, क्वांटिटी इज, क्वांटिटी डिमांडेड इज हाउ मच, क्वांटिटी डिमांडेड इज 1, डेल्टा क्यू इज माइनस 3, राइट, एंड माइनस 3 3, एंड दिस इज माइनस 2. दिस इज गोइंग टू बी आंसर, इज गोइंग टू बी 6, राइट. सो इट इज गोइंग टू बी व्हाट, 6, 4 टू द 12, 2 डिवाइड बाय 12, 6. तो 6 इज योर प्राइस इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड. इसका मतलब क्या है, इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड इज ग्रेटर देन 1 बिकॉज इट इज 6. सो दिस इज हाउ वी हैव डन द सम. इफ यू जस्ट गो थ्रू द सम, So this is how you people are going to do your sum. Right? So first method, this is very easy. This is your proportion of price method, or proportion of percentage method. Another method is geometric method. Second method is geometric method. Geometric method we'll do now. Geometric method. अब इसमें होता क्या है? Geometric method measures price elasticity of demand at different points. इसमें हम क्या करेंगे? Price elasticity of demand को different points पे measure करेंगे. We are going to draw a diagram and then we are going to measure price elasticity of demand at different points. At different points. Points. We measure price elasticity of demand. You measure price elasticity of demand, right? It is also called what? Point method, right? It is also called what? Point method also. Now we'll just take an example. Formula is going to be what? Lower segment upon upper segment. Formula kya hoga? Price elasticity of demand is equals to lower segment upon upper segment. This is going to be the formula. Try and understand again. The second way of measuring price elasticity of demand is geometric method, which is also known as point method. Here we are going to measure the elasticity of demand at different points on a curve. Formula is going to be lower segment upon upper segment. Lower segment upon upper segment. Let's make a diagram. This is your diagram. Just try and understand. Y-axis, x-axis. Here we are showing price. Here we are showing quantity demanded. Right? We are going to draw a straight line. ये हमारा डिमांड कर्व बन गया, राइट? इसको हम नाम दे देंगे M. सेंटर का जो नम पॉइंट है, उसको हम नाम, इसको भी एक नाम दे दीजिए, ठीक है? टेक इट P and this is your N. So we are given this name. You can see again, this is a diagram. This is a y-axis showing price. This is a x-axis showing quantity. We are drawing a demand curve and at the center we are pointing by P. You can give any name to it. This is point M and this is point N, right? The formula I told you is lower segment upon upper segment. Now in this figure, MN is a straight demand curve. Yeah, here MN is a straight straight demand curve. Here MN is a what? Straight demand curve. MN is your straight demand curve. P is a specific point of the demand curve. This P is a specific point of demand curve. Again, I'm explaining. MN is a straight demand curve and P is a specific point, right? The point P divides the demand curve into two equal parts. Point P divides demand curve in two parts, two equal parts. So your P point is dividing your demand curve into two equal parts, right? Lower segment PN and upper segment PN. So PN is your lower segment. PN is lower segment and PM is upper. PM is upper. I hope you are understanding this. This is very, very simple, right? Now, elasticity of at point P is estimated to be the ratio between upper segment and lower segment. Now, we are going to measure point elasticity of demand here, 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 here and here. Right? So, again, I am repeating till the point I have taught you. Just listen. This is your what? Demand curve. This is your geometric method. We also call it point method. Now here we are going to measure demand curve on a here we are going to measure elasticity of demand on a point, on a straight curve on different points. Now we have drawn a straight demand curve here, downward sloping demand curve. The name of the demand curve is MN. The name of demand curve is MN, right? And we are putting a point out here. We are giving it name, just dividing the line into two equal parts. We are giving it a name P. So P is the point where the demand curve is equally divided into two equal parts. The upper part is known as upper segment, that is MP. Lower part is known as lower segment, that is PN. Right? Now we are going to measure the demand curve. I mean, P is dividing your curve into two equal parts, right? Remember, the formula is lower segment upon upper segment. So we are going to start measuring the elasticity of demand. So now, elasticity of demand, okay, at point P, we are talking about PN upon PM. The formula is lower segment is PN upon PM. This is the formula, lower segment upon upper segment, right? Lower segment upon upper segment. So both are equal. Both are what? Equal. So the elasticity of demand is here going to be 1. Because both are equal, they cut jayenge, the elasticity of demand is here is going to be 1. So elasticity of demand here is 1. Okay? This is your unity. Now, next is your at point N. At point N. Now we'll talk about at point N. Elasticity of demand at point N. N mein kya hoga? Your lower segment to kuch hai nahi. Lower segment to kuch hai nahi, bacha hi nahi. So lower segment is going to be what? Here it's 0, right? Dhyan se dekh rahe ho aap? Theek hai? So 0 upon n m, 0 upon n m. Yahan pe bhi ek point bana dijiye, isko a naam de dijiye. Yahan pe bhi ek point bana dijiye, isko kya naam de dijiye? अंदर देते ए नाम दे दीजिए, यहाँ पे बी नाम दे दीजिए. सो लोअर सेगमेंट तो है नहीं, तो ये हो गया. तो यहाँ पे इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड क्या हो गई? इक्वल्स टू बी 0. नाउ इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड एट विच पॉइंट? नाउ इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड एट पॉइंट एन, ऊपर के एक्सट्रीम पर. पहले मैंने नीचे आ गया, फिर नीचे का ऊपर का कर रहे हैं एट पॉइंट एन. तो लोअर सेगमेंट है सारा का सारा, तो एम एन नीचे आ जाएगा, एम एन अपॉन 0. सो हियर इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड इज गोइंग टू बी इनफिनाइट. ठीक है, एट पॉइंट ए यहां पे इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड इज इक्वल्स टू बी इनफिनाइट. हियर इट इज गोइंग टू बी 0. नाउ लेट्स टॉक अबाउट ए. एट पॉइंट ए अगेन लोअर सेगमेंट कितना हुआ? ए एन अपॉन ए एम अपॉन ए एम. सो यहां पे ए एन इज ग्रेटर देन ए एम. ए एन इज ग्रेटर देन ए एम, सो इलास्टिसिटी ऑफ डिमांड इज गोइंग टू बी ग्रेटर देन 1. एंड द लास्ट इज एट पॉइंट B. It's going to be B N upon B M. B M. Right? So at this point, your B N is going to be smaller than B M. So here elasticity of demand is going to be smaller than 1. So this is how it happens. You can go through it easily and just have a look here. This is a geometric method which is also known as point method. Here we are going to measure the elasticity of demand on different points on a straight demand curve. So we have drawn a straight demand curve here. This is point P which divides the demand curve in two equal parts. Then the uppermost point is M, which I have given name. You can change the name. This is M, this is N. And the lower segment is again divided into two parts, and the upper segment is also divided into two parts. The formula is lower segment upon upper segment. So at point P, the two parts are equal. So Pn upon Pm are equal. That's why elasticity of demand is going to be equal to be 1. At point N, the extreme point, the down point we are talking about, here pe lower segment kuch hai hi nahi, to humne 0 likha hai, baaki sara upper segment hai, to Nm likha hai, to elasticity of demand is going to be 0, which is perfectly inelastic. That at point M, that is extreme point, here the lower segment is, upper segment is 0, and the low hole is lower segment, so Mn upon 0, here elasticity, any number divided by 0 gives you infinite. So here the elasticity of demand is going to be infinite. At point A, the elasticity of demand is going to be greater than 1. Why? Because the upper segment, the lower segment is greater than the upper segment, so elasticity of demand is greater than 1. And at point B, here the elasticity of demand is going to be smaller than 1, because your upper segment is smaller than the lower segment. So I hope, children, this is very very clear to you, and in case you have any queries, any questions, you can WhatsApp me. By that time, take care of yourself, stay at home, stay safe, stay smart also, dear.